Hey everyone, Ross Marchand here, Director of Policy for the Taxpayers Protection Alliance. And just to make your day in self-isolation a little bit more exciting, I have with me today American Legislative Exchange Council Chief Economist and Executive Vice President of Policy, Jonathan Williams. Jonathan, how are you doing today?
Well, doing well and good to be with you, my friend.
Oh, crazy developments going on. Tax changes, tax policy changes happen seemingly every day. And the latest developments, it seems as though most states have extended filing and payment deadlines from April 15th to July 15th in lockstep with the federal government. Is this a good idea? Do you think the filing and payment deadline should be extended further out? What says you?
Well, it's absolutely a good idea to give individual families and small businesses, large businesses alike, some relief during this period in a way, as President Reagan once described to a staffer during one of the crises of the 1980s, don't just stand there, go undo something. And so removing government barriers, whether they're regulation or tax filing deadlines or tax payment deadlines, I think that's all very positive free market way to address the real crisis that we face, unprecedented economic times, as we all know. And so I think, you know, getting the heavy hand of government and the tax collector off of individuals and businesses right now is exactly the right line of thinking. And of course, this started at the federal level, as you noted, and it's not something that usually ever gets put in the same sentence as generosity in the IRS, but that's what happened this last few weeks, is we got the federal deadline from April 15th to July 15th. And now we're seeing in a very short amount of time, I think we're seeing the power of state policy and that the flexibility of states to piggyback on the federal changes, some automatically do and then others by regulation or governor's executive order or even by state legislation. The vast majority have moved their state filing deadlines and payment deadlines to July 15th. There's a few holdouts. Unfortunately, the state in which I pay taxes, the Commonwealth of Virginia, is really the state that's going to have the most prompt filing deadline, not even moving it back one day, which is really damaging, I think, for Virginia taxpayers. That's the decision that Governor Northam has made at this point. I suppose it could be revisited, but I think overall the trend has been very positive in this regard.
Sure, and looking back at what they have done, it's very encouraging. But moving forward and looking into the future, what can state and local and federal policymakers do to further have relief, further introduce relief to households and businesses and make sure they're dealing with a lot of expenses, healthcare expenses, keeping food on the table, keeping their kids educated? How can they get taxes and regulations out of the way on a more permanent basis moving forward?
Yeah, well, that's a really important question. And one thing that I've seen that I think is going to be taken up by state lawmakers when they come back into their sessions, the vast majority of states are either paused or adjourned for the year. They're going to have to come back and deal with revenue shortfalls because they base their budgets on very optimistic scenarios pre-crisis in many cases, not to mention the massive unfunded pension obligations that continue to pile up at the state level. And so while they're back, I think they're going to address some tax issues. One of them is, I think, could be really key coming out of the crisis once we can get this economy reopened again, is we're going to have a lot of businesses, a lot of small businesses with net operating losses. And we're going to probably have some states want to do what the federal government did. And this kind of fell under the headlines as part of the last part of the CARES Act, was to allow more flexibility in claiming net operating losses. And so that's something that I think states are going to piggyback and have a discussion on how they want to handle that. The last thing we want to do is obviously have companies with lots of profits on their books having to come in and pay taxes with no cash flow right now. And so I think having some flexibility around claiming net operating losses and carrying them back to match profitable years over the last several years is probably something that states are going to consider. But then when you look at the individual and family side of things, I think there's got to be a thinking about the overall tax climate and business climate after this pandemic is behind us, and how do we make sure the fundamentals are good, that we're cutting taxes and we're making sure that individuals and families can get through this as well. Because, you know, it's one thing to say, okay, we can open the economy, and that's going to be an essential discussion over the coming days and coming weeks. But how do we make sure that people have jobs to go back to and companies can reopen their doors? And many of the things that I worry about the most is the small business sector.
Right. And so much of what we're talking about now is temporary. It's a temporary response to such a tumultuous time, unprecedented situation, public health crisis to occur in our lifetime. But how do we balance that short-run consideration with long-term reforms?
I think we always have to keep principles at the heart of the discussion. Is while there may be some very short-term things that are being done out of necessity for health reasons, out of necessity to kind of keep people afloat during a short period of time, I think it's awfully important. Exactly what you said is that much of this needs to be temporary, needs to be targeted, and then we need to unwind many of these factors that, unfortunately, if we learn the lessons, I think, from 2008, is we didn't unwind many of the big government facets trying to come out of the financial crisis quickly enough, and that really inhibited that recovery. And it was the slowest economic recovery coming out of a recession since World War II out of the financial crisis. Let's learn from our mistakes there, and let's make sure we can get rid of government micromanagement and allow the private sector and individuals and entrepreneurs to flourish. And a lot of that is getting government out of the way, like President Reagan outlined from his principles from the 1980s. How do we get tax burdens down permanently? And to do that, Ross, we're going to have to tackle the $23 trillion of national debt now that we're adding to, it seems like, by the week. There's some of it for very good reason right now. But once we're through this stage, how do we tackle government overspending at the federal, state, and local level? And how do we tackle the national debt?
Sure. Well, certainly no shortage of challenges. Where can we read more? Where can we find some of your great work?
So ALEC.org is a great spot to find lots of different things that we've been working on here. In fact, we have a policy solutions guide for state lawmakers with 30 different ideas that will remove regulations and help get our economy back to work as soon as physically possible. And so I encourage people to go to ALEC.org and check it all out.
Great. And please visit our website as well, protectingtaxpayers.org. Well, thanks so much, Jonathan.
Thanks for having me. Good to be with you.
Thanks. Take care.